Dr. Miller, you agree that COVID is not as infectious as the measles, so you both agree on that. But you do have a disagreement with the aerosols. Explain the difference between an aerosol, right, and a respiratory droplet, and why you think that aerosols can cause a spread.
Yeah, I don't think that measles being so infectious is how we need to categorize infectious aerosol-driven diseases, right? So droplets are really large particles, and they're propelled through the air easily and fall to the ground due to gravity. But they're really only important during coughing and sneezing, and they're really easy to see and understand. But aerosols are these tiny particles that linger for hours, and they are released when you talk and even breathe. And you throw out thousands to even hundreds of thousands of these particles through your mouth, and they can travel up to speeds up to 60 miles an hour. I mean, we used to think that TB was transmitted by droplets, but research eventually showed that it was only transmitted through aerosols. And you want to think of yourself like, you have this pig pen effect, like a personal cloud around you, and it has skin flakes in it and threads from your clothes, but it also could contain aerosols that have virus in them. And so this cloud is where this aerosol and droplets are, but then the aerosol can travel much farther and linger for hours inside.
So the aerosols can not only travel further because they're much smaller, but they also can last longer in the air. So the idea is, if someone is talking or singing loudly in a particular area and they leave and you walk into that area 15 minutes later, it's possible that the aerosols could be breathed in and give you the infection.
That's definitely right. And that is why we say indoors is such higher risk than outdoors. And we've seen transmission tracking research that shows, you know, over 300 cases that were transmitted, only one happened outside between two people talking. So inside we see a lot more risk because it's a small volume. You release this aerosol, it can stay inside for a long time unless you take it out through ventilation or you bring in outside clean air.
Okay, I want to share a video with the both of you. It's scientists in the Netherlands created aerosol spreading from someone wearing a loose-fitting mask. As you can see, the simulated breath travels behind the mask wearer's head. Dr. Miller, after seeing this, can you explain why this proves it's especially risky to stand or sit behind someone who has a loose mask? This drives me crazy when I see it in stores.
Yes, the mask is so important. It's a source control. Like, it's keeping the droplets and particles, you know, out from projecting onto people. But it can sneak out the gaps in your mask really easily. And so just imagine if that person even didn't have the mask on, all of these particles would be transmitted and generated out in front of them. But now with the gaps, it's just flowing behind you and it's putting everybody at high risk.
And Dr. Gandhi, you know, you go outside, you see people who are wearing their masks, but they're just covering their mouth. I mean, explain to people why it's also important to cover your nose.
It is important for the person who's wearing a mask to wear a mask that fits over their nose and mouth, because you don't want to transmit it to others. You definitely don't want it to come out of your nose and mouth and get to others. And then it's important for you to wear a mask, not just for another person, but for yourself, because then you're protecting getting in the virus into the very orifices where it enters. It enters in your nose and mouth. So you're just doing something for yourself and society by wearing a mask.
Well, Dr. Gandhi and Dr. Miller, thank you for joining us. Listen, I think it's a good thing, actually, in some ways, that everyone's not agreeing, because this shows that we're all still learning, that there's a difference of opinion, and why it's even more important to be extremely cautious during these uncertain times. Thank you so much.